Whitley lot.
Excuse me.
Yeah, and I'm going to show the Chapin house this morning. Yeah. Okay, yeah, I got to go too. Talk to you later. Bye. Come on, boys. It's going to be late.
You mean you haven't sold the Chapin house yet?
Yeah. Isn't that the house with 99 bedrooms and one bathroom?
Got four bedrooms and one bath, and there's nothing wrong with that house. It just needs a little remodeling. Todd, finish your juice.
Needs an outhouse is what it needs.
You know, Brian, maybe you could use some of that great wit and intelligence on your English final today, huh?
Oh, cold.
Not in the house.
Not bad.
Okay, you guys, let's go.
Mom, David wants me to come over after school today. His folks got him a snake.
Oh, nice.
Can I have one?
Yeah, when you're 21.
Mom, how come it's so boring in Ridgeline?
It's supposed to be boring in Ridgeline. Have a good day.
School?
Sure.
It's almost summer.
Mom, I've got practice today. Can you pick me up at 4:30?
4:30? Yeah, okay. Hey, you guys. I love you.
Mom!
Is practically brand new. The Chapins have put a lot of work into that house.
Yeah, it's too bad they didn't put it in another bathroom.
You know, I think they'd be willing to come down a couple $1,000s. Mrs. Chapin's been transferred to Seattle, and they're really anxious to sell.
Well, I want to thank you, Dee. You've been a big help. I'm going to have to think about it and get back to you.
Okay, whatever I can do, Evelyn.
Okay, thanks a lot.
Mm-hmm. All right. You know, the great thing about living on this street is that there's hardly any traffic, so it's a real safe place for kids.
See ya.
Girlfriend.
Happy anniversary, sweetie.
Happy anniversary. I can't believe I gave you a wallet.
I can't either.
This is from us. It's just a card.
Oh, it's very thoughtful of you. Thank you.
What?
Look, if you don't want us to call you that, it's no big deal.
Are you kidding me? You guys are the best.
I am so happy.
Me too.
So much. And the boys love you just as much as I do.
They were really something to me.
Yeah.
What do you think they'd like to have? A little brother or a little sister? I think a little sister.
Nah, little brother.
Mike.
I know. It's just that, you know, before it would have seemed like we were replacing them, but now the boys have been with us for 3 years and they're secure, Dee. We're a family.
Son.
I don't want to have a baby with you.
What a great game, Todd. You're a cinch for varsity next year.
So are a lot of guys. Coach says not to get complacent.
Mom, what's complacent?
Complacent is when you become so sure of yourself that you let your guard down and the other guys just come right on in and pounce. Honey, you okay?
Quick, turn right. There's a house on Sycamore I want to see. Turn!
Okay, it's pepperoni and olives on one half and sausage and peppers on the other, all right?
No olives on my half. Well, I don't want them on my half.
All right, you guys hit the showers. I'll call you when the food's here. Hurry back, okay?
Evening, ma'am. Are you Dee Johnson?
Mm-hmm.
I'm sorry to bother you. I'm a federal marshal. Will you step outside with me, please? I need to check the registration on your car. Dee Johnson, you're wanted by the state of West Virginia. You escaped from the state penitentiary. You have the right to remain silent. If you give up that right, anything you say can be against the court of law. You have the right to an attorney. And out of board, 1-1 will be appointed to you.
My board.
As you wish.
Please,
you understand?
Please, let me talk to my board.
You understand?
Please, let me talk to my board. I don't want that to happen. Please. Let me talk to my board.
Mixed up with somebody else. Some Virginia.
Porter. It's Virginia Porter.
Well, obviously, there's some woman, some criminal out there whose credit cards or motor vehicle record or something got switched with yours in some computer somewhere. It's mistaken identity. It happens all the time.
Mike.
I don't want you to worry. I'm going to get the best lawyer. We're going to clean
Mike,
this mess up. You're not going
to... I want you to listen to me now, okay? I'm sorry.
Sorry for what?
It's not a case of mistaken identity. I was in prison 10 years ago for armed robbery and I escaped.
You're Virginia Porter?
I always meant to tell you. I planned to tell you. But the longer I waited, the harder it got. And then there was the boys. And they needed a chance. They needed a chance.
Yeah. married Wayne back in West Virginia. I was young. My whole life revolved around my kids. They were everything.
But we're gonna blow it out, sugar. Mama's gonna help. Ready? One, two, three. Oh, you did! You're a big girl now, ain't you? Yeah, you look too tidy. Okay, now. Todd, you wanna go give out all those napkins for us? Okay? Okay, whoops. There you go. Mama, save a big piece for Wayne, all right?
Well, seems to me that husband of yours wanted cake. He would have been here by now to have some.
That's all right. Daddy be here. Daddy be here.
How are you, Mr. Blue Hands?
I got it all figured out. As soon as Wayne gets some work, I'm going to save up a little every month.
Well, as soon as Wayne gets a job, we could all save a little money every month.
Well, all I want is a real house. It don't even have to be big. But it's got to have a backyard and a big old tree for the boys to climb and rooms for all my babies.
Well, don't get your hopes up too high, Jenny. I think you just got to take life as it comes.
Oh, Mama. Hi.
Hey, darling.
You miss out. You miss a good party.
Well, I had places to be.
Children grow up fast, Wayne. You miss it, and you don't get no second chance.
Oh, well, thank you for that observation. Hey, look, I got the kid a present. Look at that. Look at that. It's got five blades. Boy needs a good pocket knife like that.
Yeah, nice. Brian's just a baby, you know.
Well, it seems like I can't do nothing right around here, can I? No,
I didn't mean
what's
it like
the...
that. Oh, we got some wieners and... there's plenty of potato salad.
You didn't fix no supper?
Well, I was busy with the boys, honey. But look, this is real good. I made it myself. It's good. And there's lots of cake, too. Okay, here you go. There's your beer. There's your napkin, okay? Wayne, honey.
Now. What, you think I'm going to hit you?
No, I just...
Oh, what? How come you're looking at me like that?
Now, why don't you just calm down, huh?
You shut up! You shut up! This is between me and my wife. This is my house.
Hey, Wayne, baby, you can wake up the boy.
Well, let him hear! Let him wake up! Let him see how a man gets treated around here when he comes home. Quit looking at me like that!
Visits up.
We're here to see Virginia Porter.
See your ID, please.
Mike Johnson.
Visitation's restricted to immediate family.
She's my wife.
What about him? Well, let's go, Todd.
I'm gonna wait right here.
Todd!
I left my wallet in the car, okay?
All right, let's go back to the car and get your wallet now.
Hi, Mommy.
Oh, hi, sweetie. Come here, baby. Come here.
You guys, there's some stuff I have to tell you that I never told you before. About things that happened when you were little. Now, I don't want you to think that what I did was okay. It wasn't. But I want you to understand how it happened. Now, we don't have much time, so I need you to listen.
Well, I don't really want to hear it, okay?
Well, I'm afraid you're gonna hear it one way or the other. And I want you to hear it from me, honey.
Itsy bitsy spider went up the water spout.
Yeah.
Then came the rain, washing the spider out.
Come on,
Ginny,
I know you're in there.
Mama.
No, he's not.
Come on,
baby. Go to the bedroom.
Open
up before I break the door down.
Okay, come on. Get in there. Come on. Ginny, just stay in here. You don't come out until I say so. Okay, stay in here.
You go away, Wayne. You're not supposed to be here. I got me a court order.
Oh, come on, Ginny. All I want to do is talk to you. Ain't no harm in talking, is there?
We've been through this before. You can't come in. We ain't getting back together this time. Not never.
Ginny, I want to see him. I got a right to see my boys.
Well, that's up to the judge now.
Oh, yeah? Oh, yeah. Well, you're going to be sorry. You can't take away my sons. Ain't no judge dumb enough to let some stupid woman take my sons.
Yeah, Todd's asleep, so when he wakes up, give him some soup. It'll make him feel better. And don't open the door for anyone, especially Wayne. And don't listen to anything he says. He's just a big talker, that's all.
Don't worry.
Don't pay him no mind. Okay, now, you're going to go to Annie, and she's going to read you a good story.
He's going to be just fine.
Okay, go on in and lock the door.
Okay.
Okay.
I love you. I love you.
All right, let's move it back. Move it back. Nan, you can't go in.
No. What the hell happened? What's going on? I told him to go away like you said. But he had a gun. I didn't know what to do. Did you say where he was going? He was going to take the kids someplace so far away, you'll never find them.
When Wayne took you boys, he just vanished. And even when the police stopped looking, I never gave up. Never. Never.
It says right there in the separation agreement that he's not supposed to come near me or the boys. They made Wayne post a $500 bond just so he'd stay away.
Oh, $500.
That's a whole lot of money to us.
And you expect that'd keep a man from his children if he want them bad enough?
Well, what are you saying, that a court order don't mean nothing?
All I'm saying, little lady, is you done sold your kids for $500.
I didn't sell nothing. You and everybody knows that Wayne Porter kidnapped those children. So how is it the police have given up? And every damn lawyer I talk to don't want to do anything about it. I've been trying to find them for 6 months now.
I am truly sorry for what you're going through, ma'am. But I can't very well take your ex-husband to court unless I know where he is. Now, can I?
Thank you.
What do you have, Merle?
Give me a beer. Hey, Jenny. I heard about your kids. Tough break.
Yeah. Well, life's full of them, ain't it?
Can I get you something?
I'm fine, Merle.
Hey, you don't look fine. Listen, I just want to say, if you need some help, I know some people.
In this world, police, laws, and courts, that's rich folks' justice. Regular folks, like us, we gotta make our own justice. Now, the police, they'll look for a rich woman's kids, but you, well, you're gonna have to find yours yourself. Honey, it's a hard day when you find out what this world's really like, huh?
Okay, Pinky, now, what's it gonna take to track them down?
Well, you understand, I'm just doing this strictly as a favor. There gonna be expenses, of course. I'll say $250 a week.
I don't have that kind of money.
Here. It's okay. I'll find you the rest tomorrow.
And I'm gonna find your boys in less than 1 week. I promise.
I'll pay you back, I swear.
Oh, I know.
Thanks, Merle. Yeah. I'd almost given up hope of finding him.
Hey, let's see that pretty smile. Yeah. Good night, Jenny.
He's living in a trailer park right outside Oklahoma City.
We could be there by tomorrow.
Well, no, honey. See, the thing is that he's moved on. He took them boys and cleared out. But we got the scent now. It won't be long, darling. Oh, I'm afraid you're all a little bit short this week.
Hey. He already gave you over $750.
If you want the best, you gotta pay for the best. I'm just sorry I can't do more for you, darling.
You just keep looking for my boys. We'll find the money. Don't you worry.
Okay.
You all right?
Yeah.
I won't be long.
Merle.
Go, go, go!
Ha ha.
I do for you.
Got much passion
in
you. Don't shoot that. Whatever you want. Give
it to me. Give it to me. Come on. Don't shoot. Come on. Back up. Stop right there.
I believe you had enough for that tonight. Hey, you quit thinking about what happened. You're gonna bring us bad luck.
Don't.
You like things good enough when we were living high off the money, but the first sign of trouble.
What are we doing, Merle?
What?
What are we doing, huh? What are we doing?
Come on.
We ain't any closer to finding my boys than we was 3 months ago.
I don't start that
and
again.
KB is just using us for
hey,
our money.
I don't want to hear this. We've been through this before.
If you weren't so full of yourself playing Bonnie and Clyde.
Huh?
Oh. He ain't looking for my kids. He's just laughing
you
at us.
You shut up about those kids. I treat you good, don't I? Start thinking about me some. I'm all you got.
Well, I don't want you. I want my boys.
I ain't gonna hang around for this.
I didn't know what to do next. I hadn't seen you boys in over a year. And nothing was making sense to me anymore. Nothing.
Solitaire stone. Think you'll like that. I'll be right with you.
Okay.
I think you'll like that. That's nice. Excuse me just a second. Can I help you, ma'am?
Yeah, I want you to give me some of your money. Now, hold on there. Come on back now. Come on.
I ain't got none. It's Friday. My wife just went to the bank.
Okay, well, just give me something. Here, give me some of them watches there.
Yeah. I could open that case there for you if just let me get a key.
Fox.
Silent. If you give up that right, anything you say can and will be used against you in a court of law. You have the right to an attorney. If you cannot afford one, one will be appointed for you.
I know that this all sounds crazy, but I was so confused and so desperate that I just didn't care if I went to jail. The only thing that I wanted was to find out where you boys were and if you were safe.
You didn't kill anybody, did you?
No. But I was sentenced to 12 years in prison.
Thank you.
feet.
No, I did, Todd. That's okay. Todd, that's enough. Come on, sit down now. Todd.
Back off, Dee.
I know how to talk to my own sons.
Your sons.
I didn't mean it like that.
Win it.
Thought they were my sons too.
You know, I think this is part of the problem. You seem to have forgotten what it means to take care of somebody.
Here. I know what it means.
Stop
to
it!
Tampering.
We don't need your help.
You've always been there to take care of him, haven't you? But who was there to take care of you? Only thing I ever thought about was you boys alone with your father. I know he was beating on you. And all I ever wanted was to get out and find you and get you away from him. I thought if I just stayed out of trouble and cleaned myself up, I could get paroled for good behavior. And after 2 years in prison, they put me on work release.
You're not very fast, are you? But I guess that doesn't really matter here. Armed robbery, huh? You're just a little slip of a thing. Damn, been quiet all morning. Jim's auto supply. Yeah. Yeah, hold on a minute.
Good morning, Jim's auto supply. I don't actually know, sir.
Get an order number.
Excuse me, sir? Yeah. Could you give me your order number? Uh-huh.
Hi.
How you holding up, Jenny?
Well, I got 582 days till I'm up for parole, so I'm just counting the days.
All right, look, I got some news about your custody case. Now, you know, ever since we found out Wayne's in Florida and we started all this, it was going to be tough.
Yeah, it's okay. Just tell me, please.
Well, the court granted Wayne permanent custody of both Todd and Brian with no visitation rights for you or your mama.
No.
Sorry.
No, Mr. Edwards, you don't understand. See, I know Wayne. I know him real well. Now, Mr. Edwards, listen to me now. He can't handle kids. He could kill those boys, Mr. Edwards. Don't anybody give a damn. Wayne was in prison before I met him. He almost killed somebody else.
Well, look, you're the one behind bars now. There just ain't nobody gonna listen to you. Judges just don't take kindly to mothers in prison. I'm sorry.
I knew I had to make a move. For the first time in 3 years, I actually knew where to find you. I just prayed that I could get there before it was too late.
You all right, Jenny?
Oh, I must be coming down with something.
Yeah. Must be that flu thing.
Yeah. Hello, yes? This is Virginia Porter. Yes, ma'am. I'm going to be working some overtime tonight. Could you send the van a little bit later? About a half an hour. Okay, thank you very much. Okay, bye.
swear, that van comes later every day. Well, you be all right now?
Yep.
You know, and files are looking pretty sharp, Missy. You're my best worker. You take care of yourself.
Hey, Jim. Thanks for everything.
Hey, Brian. You remember me, honey? You used to live with me when you were real little.
Hi. Well, now, don't this beat all?
Dishes to do. Come on now.
It's nice. See how Mama loves her boys. But don't forget about their daddy now.
Come on now. I'm tired.
It's an emergency. I'll pay you when we get there. No, please. Please. Don't you worry, we'll get
there. Hey! Hey! You trying to steal my kids? Get out! Go! Go! Huh? 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 Where you going? Huh?
Shut up! You boys, get in the bedroom now!
Please!
Go on. Get the bed.
The man of the place. It's over between us. You know that.
You escaped from jail just to be with us for like 2 days? I mean, how stupid can you be?
Shut up, Todd. Just shut up.
Why are you standing up for her?
It wasn't for 2 days. I escaped to be with you, to try to get you away from Wayne.
Well, you didn't try hard enough, did you? No wonder Dad hit you. You probably deserved it.
I said shut up!
Hey, stop it! Hey, now you listen to me. Listen to me, Todd, now. No one deserves to be hit. Not you, not me, not Brian. No one, not ever. What your father did to us was wrong.
Yeah, but at least he didn't keep leaving.
This quiet community was rocked by the news that an escaped convict has been living in its midst. Dee Johnson, mother of two boys.
All right, come on, let's go.
Do we have to? I mean, right now?
Yes, we have to. Look, guys, I told you you could stay home from school because we were going to go and see your mother. Now she's expecting us. What am I going
to
tell her?
Tell her whatever you want to. Are you and Mommy going to get divorced?
Brian. Hello. Who is this, please? I already told you guys, we're not talking to anybody. I don't care what magazine you're from. Just don't call here again.
Now, I filed this petition to keep you here in California. But if they want to extradite you to West Virginia, there's nothing we can do about it.
Oh, no. I can't go back to West Virginia, Mr. Dunn. I cannot go back there.
Dee, let me tell you something. I think that...
Where are the boys?
They didn't want to come. Because we have reporters out in front of the house now all the time.
Oh, God. Well, you're a lawyer. Can't you do something about that?
Not about the press, I'm afraid.
Great.
I was just about to tell your wife something, I might as well tell you. I think that we have a pretty good shot at a pardon. I mean, it's clear that she is no longer a threat to society. Nothing is to be gained by sending her back to prison. I think we got a pretty good shot. I'll talk to you both tomorrow, and I'll tell you more about the extradition.
Thank you, Mr. Dunn.
It's okay, Dick. You take care.
Okay. Pardon. That's good, isn't it?
I don't know who I've been living with for the last 6 years. I don't even know who you are.
Show up not knowing anybody. I always wanted to see California.
Always wanted to see California.
Dixie girl, Golden State's gonna chew you up and spit you out talking like that.
Come on, I can take care of myself.
Yeah, right. You got any money? Don't be an idiot. Take it. Hey, what is your name?
D.
D for Dixie.
Sort of.
Well, good luck, Dixie girl.
read update. The Dow Jones went down 24 points after heavy trading today.
The Dow Jones went down 24 points after heavy trading today.
Hello?
Hey, Mama. Hey, it's Jenny.
Hi, Jenny girl. How are you?
I'm fine.
Oh, it's good to hear your voice.
Yeah, it's good to hear your voice, too. I can't talk long, Mama. I just wanted to let you know that I'm okay.
The police have been looking for you. Talking to the neighbors 3 more times now.
Mama? Do you know anything at all about Brian and Todd? You heard anything?
The divorce papers, come. Now, do you want me to send them on to where you are?
Mama.
Ginny. Honey. Now, you know that I love you, don't you?
Yeah, I know you love me.
Maybe it is time that you get used to the idea that you ain't gonna get the kids back.
I don't want to hear that.
I think I'll have the spaghetti dinner.
Spaghetti dinner, and would you like soup or salad with that?
Those first 2 years in California, I not only changed the way I looked, but I kept on working hard to better myself. I knew I was going to get the boys back. I just didn't know how.
And time. If you're as accurate as you are fast, we'd be lucky to get you.
It's listed at 180,000. I have a feeling that the clients don't want to go down on that. Let me put it this way. I'm going to be straight up front with you. So if you come in with some...
Colonial Realty? Oh, I'm sorry. Mr. Johnson isn't in right now. Mm-hmm. Yes. Yes, I'll tell him. Okay, goodbye. Oh, are you here to see Mr. Johnson? Oh, excuse me. I'm sorry. Good morning, Colonial Realty. Oh, I'm sorry, he's not in right now. Can I take a message?
Let's say 9, 10.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yes, I'll tell him just as soon as he walks in the door.
Good idea to see the property again.
Wait, you're welcome, Mr. Phelps. Bye now. I'm sorry. Can I help you?
Well, you can start by giving me my messages.
See, you two have met?
Not exactly.
Mr. Johnson?
Mike Devilson, D. Mike Johnson.
Nice to meet you.
Hi.
Look, I gotta get home, shower, and then look at that building on 4th. Welcome to Colonial Realty.
Oh, I understand.
I got the job.
I saw you on those phones. You sounded great.
And she tested just fine.
Was there something else you think I should know?
No.
Fine. I'll call in later.
That's the boss?
Mm-hmm. We sponsor a kid's baseball team. Mike's the coach. Come on, I'll show you your desk.
Hi.
The McCoy papers? You gotta sign them?
Oh, right. Come on in.
Did I wake you up?
Not really. I've just got a cold and this place is such a mess.
Oh, no, it's not. It's really nice. Got warm in here.
It was only supposed to be temporary. Divorce. She had a better lawyer than I did.
Oh, they're right here. It's some soup. Chicken noodles. Nothing fancy. You might.
Soup?
Well, I hope it makes you feel better.
It was great. You're going to be a great mother someday. Did I say something?
No, I am a mother. I have two boys. They're with my ex-husband.
Where?
In Florida. He had a better lawyer than I did.
Well, I love kids. I always wanted a whole shoe full. Shoe full. You know, Mother Hubbard, Mother Goose, Mother Nature, one of them, I don't know. It's a joke.
Guess I better keep my day job, huh?
Yeah, you better. You better sign the McCoy papers, too. Huh? Here.
Now that's it?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm gonna get these out in the mail today.
No, those can wait till tomorrow. Now, come on. There's a new listing over on Grove Street. I have to see it. Check it out with me.
Okay.
We're here. No, D, it's across the street.
Oh, but look at this one. Isn't it wonderful? Reminds me of Donna Reed's house. I think it would be impossible to be anything but happy in a house like that. Don't you think? Oh, God.
I know.
What the hell did you do to my car? I don't believe this. Why don't you do that stuff in the privacy of your own home? What are you, a couple of 16-year-olds?
Hi, Todd.
Hi.
How you doing? Todd, I really want to see you.
Yeah. Well, I've been real busy with school and stuff lately.
Uh-huh. How's the team doing? You guys gonna make the playoffs?
I quit the team.
You quit the team? Why?
I gotta go.
Todd, no matter what's happened, I'm still your mother.
Yeah, right. Just because we've been living with you for the last 3 years doesn't make you a mother.
I'm 14, okay? I don't need a mother. I can take care of myself.
Well, what are we going to do about Todd? He's so angry.
What did you expect? He's scared to death. He trusted you. You let him down.
I wanted to tell you so many times, Mike. I almost did.
Why didn't you? Do you think I'd turn you in?
Of course not.
What was I? Is there some kind of cover for you? Are you just using me? Has this all been a lie? How long has it been since you told the truth to anyone?
Everything all right?
I was going to wait till after dinner to do this, but the way my stomach feels right now, I don't think I'd be able to take a bite.
You okay?
Yes. Before I met you, I'd given up on ever being close to anybody again. Didn't know if I wanted to, didn't know if it was worth the risk. And one day I walked into the office and there you were. And something inside of me just came alive again. It scared the hell out of me. You took me completely by surprise. Now I don't know that I can live the rest of my life without you. I love you, Dee. Would you? Will you marry me?
Like, there's something that... Yeah. Oh, yeah. I'll marry you.
Oh. Hold on.
It's beautiful.
Belongs right there.
Keep those eyes closed.
They're closed.
I am watching you.
You are not watching me.
Keep them closed now. Give me your hand. Come on.
Okay.
Come on. There's a step up here. Step okay. up.
Okay.
Whoop. Come on. Keep them closed. Keep them closed.
I'm keeping them closed. Come on.
Feel your way. Feel your way. Feel anything yet?
It's mine.
All right. Stay. Wait. Step. Hold. One step.
Well, how do you like your new house, Mrs. Johnson?
What are you talking about?
This is your house! It's yours! I bought it for you!
I didn't have anybody else in mind.
I didn't know this was on the market.
Well, we had a hell of a time keeping it a secret from you. And don't you tell me that you're not thrilled!
It's so big!
Oh, we're going to need a lot of room. Because we're going to hire the best lawyer in this country, and we're going to go and bring your boys back. And then, we're going to give them a little brother or sister.
Come on, aren't you the one who told me that it was impossible to be anything else but happy in this house? Now smile.
What's gonna happen to us?
I don't know. This is not just that you lied to me. It's that you didn't trust me enough to tell me the truth.
But I didn't trust anybody when I knew how much you cared about me, how much I cared about you. I couldn't tell you. If I told you, I would have made you an accessory. And if I got caught, your life would have been ruined.
And it's not now.
You're not the only one hurt here, you know. I made mistakes. Big ones. I made a complete mess of things. And I've got no one to blame but me. But I can't do anything about that now. The past is the past. And if I have to go back to prison to pay for what I've done, then that's what I have to do. And if you're not going to stick around, I have to know. Because I've got children to think about. Are you going to be around?
I have to go.
Oh, Mike, what would you have done if I had told you? Would you still have married me?
I don't know.
Hey, Mama. You heard anything about the boys?
Ginny, honey, I got some news for you.
What?
I've been talking to Wayne some lately.
Yeah?
He said you can come and see your boys.
What?
Now, he's married again, and she's 8 months pregnant. He says he don't harbor no grudge no more. Ginny... Honey, do you hear me?
Yeah, I hear you, Mama.
He says you can come and see your boys anytime you want. You better start making plans.
Okay. Okay. I gotta go tell Mike.
Go tell him.
Oh, Mama. Oh, Mama, thank you so much. I love you.
I love you, baby.
I'll call you back. Okay?
Bye, baby.
Okay, bye. This is it. Thank you.
What you done to yourself?
Well, Tammy's pa asked me to come into business with him. You know, owns a couple of filling stations. I guess you could say we had a parting of the ways. Hey, come on, let's get this slap on the table, huh? I mean, a man's got a right to be paid what he's worth. Ain't that right, Tammy? I said, ain't that right, Tammy?
Yeah.
Damn straight. No, oh, where's my beer? See, I'm in business for myself now. You know, spare parts, mostly. Well, I ain't doing too bad. What the hell is this? This is shoe leather. Excuse me, I don't eat shoe leather. Just take that.
I'll get it. I'll get you another one.
Okay.
This is real good, Tammy. Everything. Aren't these potatoes good, boys? Mm-hmm, you bet. Mm-hmm.
Well, you just been paid a compliment, girl. What do you say?
Thank you.
You know, one thing I can say for you, Ginny, you was always a great cook. Boy, remember that fried chicken you used to make? Oh, God. And that cream gravy. I can still taste it. You still making that gravy? Or that husband of yours?
I don't remember. I might have made it once or twice.
Where the hell is my beer?
Get it yourself. I'll get it.
You sit down.
Wayne.
What did I tell you?
Wayne, come on now. Leave her alone.
Ah! Answer me! Answer me! Oh, what? Answer me! Yeah. You are pathetic. You boys, just get in the bedroom.
Now!
You don't know Wayne like I do. He really loves me.
Mm-hmm. That's not love, Tammy. It took me a long time to figure that one out. Well, you're gonna have a little kid running around here pretty soon. And you gotta get out while you can. You gotta get out now.
And lose my kids for good like you.
Ain't this cozy. What you two been gabbing about while I've been gone?
Nothing. Actually, you're the one I want to talk to.
Well, excuse me then.
Okay. No, I'm gonna have some later, maybe. Wayne. Now, you know that I want Brian and Todd to come and live with me, and you got a whole new family now.
Hold it.
I missed out on so much. So much.
That was your own damn fault.
You're right. Yeah. You're right about that. Wayne, I know you're a good father. And I know that you want what's best for the boys. But you and Tammy...
What in the world makes you think that I'd let you take my boys now, after all these years?
Now, just listen to me.
No!
Just...
No, you listen to me. Now, the way I see it, you're doing all right for yourself. I mean, that looks to be a genuine diamond ring. And you come all the way here from California on an airplane just like that. Jenny! Raising kids is expensive.
You gotta be kidding me. You're asking me for money? You're asking me for money after you stole my children?
I can have the cops here in 2 minutes. And I know where you live now, don't I?
How much do you want?
Well, now... I'm just gonna have to think about that.
Mama, please take
us
with you. We won't be in any trouble.
I promise.
I know you won't, honey. I know you won't. And if I could, I would. I can't right now, but I'm gonna figure out a way.
No, you won't. If you really loved us, you wouldn't leave us here.
I'm not leaving you, Todd. I'm gonna be right down the road at the motel. And I'll see you in the morning. Look, I'm gonna write down my phone number. And if you need anything, you call me. Okay?
Come on, Brian.
No. Todd, please, Brian, now you wait now. Here, you take this. You need me, you call me. Anytime. Anytime now. You call me, okay? Okay? I really do love you. And I'll see you in the morning. Okay? I promise. What's wrong, honey?
Mom! Dad's trying to kill Todd! I don't know what to do, I'm scared!
Brian, sweetie, calm down, honey.
Brian, let's go!
Brian?
God!
Brian,
What's going on?
Calm down, just calm down.
What did you do to
them? The boys is okay. They're going to be fine. They're in the house with Tammy.
What'd you do to them?
I didn't do nothing. Todd went and told him a brand new pickup.
Stop lying to me, damn it. I know you were beating on him.
You listen to me.
No, you listen to me. You want your money, fine. You got it. But I get the boys. Now, that's the deal.
You see these cops here? Take nothing to throw your butt in jail right now.
Go ahead. And you won't see a dime. Go ahead.
I'll take them. Take them. They're getting to be more trouble than they're worth anyway.
Hi. What's going on?
Tell your mother what you were doing when I got back home. I'll tell her then. They were packing up to leave. They're gonna run away.
Todd? Brian, what are you doing?
Brian and I got our own plans. We're out of here.
What are you talking about?
We're leaving.
Oh, yeah? Well, where are you going?
What difference does it make? You can't take care of us anymore.
Oh, yes, I can. No matter what happens, I am going to take care of you.
Yeah? Well, you're here. Mike's not sticking around. So we got to take care of ourselves. Come on, Brian.
Wait a minute. You're not going anywhere, Todd.
Now, listen to me. Get your damn hands off of me! You're never going to send us back to our father. Never! They'll kill us. I know it will. They'll kill us. I hate him. I wish he were dead. He's not ever going to hit on me and Brian again. Ever. I won't let him. We're going away. Somewhere you can't find us. Where he can't find us.
It's okay. You're never going back to him. I promise.
Nobody's ever going to hurt you again. You're safe. Brian is safe. Everything is fine. I'm your father now. I promise that.
I just got some information I thought you'd like to know. Wayne is in jail for manslaughter. He turned you in as part of a plea bargain. Sorry.
Yeah. I kind of thought it might be Wayne.
You mean he's in jail?
Mm-hmm.
Good.
Is there any news about the extradition?
Yes. Could be as early as next week.
I might have to go back to West Virginia, honey.
No!
Todd.
You can't let them take my mom.
Todd, it's going to be all right. We're going to go with your mother to the hearing, and we're going to stay with her just as long as it takes. It's okay.
The pardon hearing will be in about 2 weeks. That doesn't leave us much time. And we've got to get a letter of support from friends, co-workers, anybody that will testify to Dee's character, why she shouldn't have to do any more time.
It's not going to be any problem. I've already got the whole office working on it.
The evidence in this case clearly demonstrates that Dee Johnson has managed to rehabilitate herself, to return to society as a productive and honest citizen. Now, given that fact, I do not see how further punishment serves the cause of justice. My client is not a woman that deserves to be incarcerated. She is not a hardened criminal. She's not a threat to society. She's a mother. A mother who has literally spent years trying to rescue her children from an alcoholic and abusive father, to pull them out of a desperate cycle of poverty and domestic violence they were born into, to give them a loving home and a chance for a future. These boys have finally been reunited with their mother, the one person they know loves them more than anything in the world. And you have the power to keep them together or to take her away again.
How you doing? You guys okay?
What's gonna happen now?
I don't know, honey. We just have to wait and see.
Did Dunn have anything to say? Does he know anything?
I hate this. It's not fair.
Life isn't always fair. You don't always get what you deserve. Sometimes you just get what you get. And you have to make the best of it. And you can't do that all the time if you're angry. You understand? I want you guys to promise me something. That no matter what happens, you'll let the past be the past. And you'll never let anybody make you feel like you're nothing. That's why I love this man so much. Because he made me feel like I was something. And I'll always have that. No matter what. And I want you to have that too. Because you're special. You promise me?
I promise. Promise.
Okay.
They're ready.
Now we've heard the testimony, and we've seen the petition, and we've reviewed all the heartfelt letters,
of which there are very many from this community. There doesn't seem to be much doubt, Ms. Johnson, Mrs. Porter,
that you're no longer participating in the same criminal activities for which you were quite justly incarcerated in 1980. Furthermore, I'm satisfied that you've shown sufficient remorse for all that you've done. Duly noted, as well as your understandable desire to remain a mother for your two minor children. This board wants you to know that we admire and encourage your effort to become a productive member of society. At the same time, we can't condone your escape from the state prison, no matter what the motivation. Finally, we must look at the message that we would be sending to the thousands of individuals incarcerated in this state, should we grant your request for a pardon. Therefore, your request for a pardon is denied. You're hereby remanded to the state penitentiary at Moundsville to serve out the rest of your sentence, plus an additional 18 months for escape, for a total of 11 years. This hearing is adjourned.
Come on, come on. Come on, don't give up. You've come too far. I'll appeal. I'll have you up on parole. You will not do that time, I promise. I would not give it up.
I can't do this. They're not going to do this. They can't. There must be something that I can do.
Shh. It's over, Mike. It's over. Come here, guys. I love you. I love you, Bri.
I love you, Mom.
I know. You go home with Dad now. Everything's gonna be just fine. You're gonna be fine. He's gonna take real good care of you.
I love you so much.
I love you too. You know, it's so strange. For the first time in my life, I feel free. Mr. Dunn says that I'll get up on parole. Maybe we could still have that baby. Okay.
It's time.
Take him.
Boys.
You.
Stay tuned, because up next on True Movies 1, Dress Grey, Part 2. Alternatively on True Movies 2, Invisible Child. And on True Entertainment, The Waltons.
Thank you.